Stubbs, good relationship between the two of you. Here's Billy Dodge, so just listen to what we're going to say here.
Well, he has got some size of ears.
Dodge, there you go. So, obviously good spirit within the dressing room at the moment. Will you be still be that happy come quarter to five or so?
Well, I certainly hope so. We've prepared properly, you know. We're really looking forward to the match. I think it's been a long time since, you know, the semi-final. And we're just itching to get going now.
I felt just short of being an emotional Roy McGregor as his wee toddle out to the centre circle as he always does. And I saw you having a big hug with him. This is as much for that man as it is for the town and the island, isn't it?
Yeah, of course it is. He is Ross County. You know, what he's done for the club, the town and the whole area. You know, it's all about trying to help people, you know, and it would be a fantastic way to reward him today by getting some silverware.
You've had to make a couple of team decisions in your selection. Talk me through for why Brian Graham's not starting, for example.
Well, we've got good choices up front. I picked a team today that I feel, you know, is adaptable and we can change the system if we're not quite happy with the way things are going. So that was in my thoughts. Liam Boyce has been prolific all season. It was a real tough call to leave Brian out today. He's been doing ever so well and he's banged in a couple of goals recently. But I just feel that Alex's pace up top can pose problems.
Of course, it gives you an option if you need to switch things later on.
Yeah, of course it does. And what a great option to have. You know, the big man's been a pivotal part of our season this year and, you know, he was really disappointed, as you would expect, but like a true professional, you know, he's ready to go now.
So, the build-up's been interesting. I think many people have been talking about, do you toddle off to Spain or do you stay where you are? Personally, I know where I'd rather be, but that's, then again, I'm not playing in a cup final.
Well, Stubbsy's tan's looking far better than mine at this stage. You know, the weather in Dingwall hasn't been quite as warm. It's got no bearing on the match whatsoever. This is about the players. This is about how they handle the occasion. You know, it's important that they try and concentrate on just winning a game of football. And you know, whoever handles that best will come out on top.
You know, Jim, I've been talking to Alan Stubbs and you know, various people for heads about the journey they've made and they're continuing to make. But actually, Ross County, that's been a hell of an adventure yourself, haven't you, in a short time?
It has. It's been, we've never foreseen, you know how quickly we'll progress, you know, when we first took over the job, you know, but it's been fantastic. It's been exhausting at times, but very, very rewarding, and that's why we're in the game. You know, we love this type of work. You know, we thrive on the pressure, and you know, that's the be-all and end-all for me.
The good news, if you keep being successful, keep Billy Dodge off our radio station.
Well, that'll help people's ears, won't it?
Tell me, I talked to Alan Stubbs about the support, the Hibs support that come here today and has backed them. Dingwall has been all but evacuated, as you imagine, hasn't it?
Yes, it has, and if the game was on a Saturday, we would have brought, you know, another 3,000 or 4,000, you know. Yeah, there's been a lot made there, been on the Sunday from the local people, and, you know, that's been trying to get back up the road, and also, a lot of our fans are, you know, a couple of hours beyond Dingwall, you know, so for that side of things, we've lost out on a few punters, but I'm delighted Hibs are, you know, bringing such a large support. Celtic had a large support, and our fans were held there, vociferously, and you know, I'm hoping for more of the same today.
So what do you do? You've got a game midweek. What do you do with celebration?
Well, there won't be. We're a professional football club. We will be in tomorrow afternoon, you know, for a warm down and prepare for St Johnstone. You know, to win the cup would be really special, and we'll have a party the following weekend if we manage to do that.
Jim, good luck. Thanks a lot.
Jim McIntyre, it is, of course, still an awful lot to do in terms of trying to ensure that they get a top six finish as well to go with this League Cup final appearance. Both sides going through the paces down below us. We're getting ever closer to that kick-off time, just about 25 minutes or so until the action is due to get underway. I'm conscious we've kind of focused on counting the last move, but we will turn our attention back to Hibernian. But Barry, just sum up for us. I mean, you, Billy, you know the club, and your dad was in charge back in the day when County made that big step up. We spoke so many times about this fairy tale, this meteoric rise. They've lost in the Scottish Cup final, they've won a couple of Challenge Cups, there have been promotions and title wins, but this is the day, isn't it, for them?
I don't think they'll get a better chance, Richard. You know, I think in 2010 when they got to the final in the Scottish Cup against Dun United, they didn't really turn up. But today, like you said, like we spoke about, you know, they are the team in the higher division. And these chances, like Alan Stubbs said, they don't come along very often. They certainly don't come along often for provincial clubs like say, Ross County and obviously Inverness. And with Inverness winning the Scottish Cup back in May, I mean, it would just be an incredible culmination of the journey for both clubs. You know, to go up with the national cup competition, both trophies being in the Highlands would be amazing. But they know they've got a lot of hard work to do against a very good Hibs side.
Yeah, it would be astonishing, Willie, wouldn't it, to think of that? The two major cup trophies sitting in the Highlands. Who would have imagined that, even just a few years ago?
No, it's quite incredible, the story of both these clubs. I think they've been well run over the years. They've been run very prudently. And they deserve the success that comes their way. But a club like Ross County in such a small community, I mean, it's not even a provincial club, is it really? It's a community club. So you're actually going a level down to be able to, sustain Premier Division and possibly European football. And to be in a cup final for the second time, quite incredible. I think they have got a better chance than the last time they were in the cup final. I think the players are more experienced. I think the manager has put together a fine group of players, and I think they're much more capable of lifting the trophy in this occasion rather than the last occasion. But it's a wonderful story for them. I think to have the two cups in the Highlands would be incredible. I mean, it'd be incredible because I spent my time obviously playing in the Highland League at age 16 quite a number of years ago. And I think to see Highland League clubs doing so well, and you were talking about it yesterday, Barry, yourself, the other clubs within the Scottish League setup doing well too, I think it's wonderful to see that.
Yeah, it's a vibrant time, certainly, for so many of the clubs from the north. And County will be hoping that this is the day that they can land major silverware. As I say, a couple of Challenge Cups they've won in the past. They've had those promotions, those title wins to enjoy in the past. And just generally incredible story as if absolutely confirmed their place at the top table of Scottish football. But this is what they're after this afternoon, to lift that famous old trophy in a few hours' time down below us in the main stand here at Hampden Hibernia, though desperate to do just that. They've won it three times in the past. Some great have been on those sides that have enjoyed success here at Hampden. Back in 1972 and 1991, 2007, the last time they won the trophy with that 5-1 win against Killy that day. And you look back at that lineup and some of those players who have gone on to make a real name for themselves in the game. So lots at stake for both clubs. Let's just stick with the Hibs then. Just a few moments ago, Chick caught up with their chief executive, Leanne Dempster.
Leanne, tell me what this means. Well, actually, on a personal journey for you, first of all, to be part of the national final.
Well, it's always, I've not had many of these in my career, as you know, Chick, so it's lovely to achieve it in a relatively short space of time, having joined the Bernie. So I'm happy to be here, but more importantly, I'm just happy that the supporters have a chance to get back to Hampden.
You've started an incredible journey with Hibs, actually, and I think people sometimes forget he's not been at the club for 2 years yet, Alan. Are you concerned that this is an all or nothing over the next few days and the next few weeks? You know, do the best of times, the worst of times, as I said, Alan?
Well, for me, going forward for the club, it's got to be the best of times. The thing we cannot control, we can try and influence, but you just cannot control what the outcome of matches are going to be. So we just have to go into everyone and face it the same way that we do every match and try and win it. So we've got a chance to do something today, a chance to do something on Wednesday, and then ultimately between now and the end of the season, a chance to still get ourselves promoted. So that's what we're working to, and I think everybody who's come to the stadium today is probably not thinking about what's happening next week, probably not thinking about promotion at the minute, but moreover just about this match today.
I'm going to still have to pursue this, but if you're given the choice, what is the most important? I mean, Hibs haven't won a Scottish Cup since, I think you might have heard, this 1902.
Well, for me, the most important thing for us this year is promotion. So everybody will kind of say, what do you want?
You would take a bullet on this, taking a bullet.
I don't want to take any bullets.
If I were your magic Mary, God help us, you would, and I could give you one, you would say promotion.
Club wants promoted, but we want to, we're here at Hampden today, so I'm not even thinking, to be honest, I'm genuinely not even thinking about what's happening next week. I'm thinking about today, but everything that we're working towards is about moving the club up the league. It's about getting back into the Premier League, where I genuinely feel, do you ever rightly belong? I think you need to earn that right, and we need to earn that right to get back up. I don't think there's any given that that it's going to happen. We need to work hard to make it happen.
The Burnley and its football club, though, have taken huge strides in the right direction over the last, whatever, year and a half.
I think there's just been, I think when sometimes when you when things don't go your way, relegation was a point of real difficulty for the club. What happens? You kind of get back together, you work really hard, new people come in, there's a whole raft of new people, check, you know that, myself, George, Alan, everybody included. It's a different focus, a different determination perhaps, a different approach, and I think supporters can see that, they can see that we want the success for Hibs. We want the success actually for the game in Scotland. I think the game in Scotland is really flourishing and we absolutely want to be part of that.
Good luck.
Thanks, kid.
Leanne Dempsey, yeah, it means so much to Burnley. I mean, it's selfish that you're stopping there. Of course, Willie, they want promotion, they want to be back up in the top flight. Despite what Chick might have been alluding to there, there's no way he is a fairy godfather or indeed godmother, and he cannot grant wishes. you simply cannot make decisions like that when you're in football. You take what comes as you go along and you try to be as successful as you can, I suppose.
I think you want to win it all, do you not?
That's where your mindset should be. I don't think you should be prioritising. Yeah, I can understand where it comes from, and if you're sitting in a boardroom and you're looking at the situation and you're looking at finances and looking at where you want to be, then you can have a solution in front of you. Where if you were in three competitions, which one would you rather take first, and you can have your priorities there? But I think as a manager, you want everything. You don't want to come to a cup final and miss it. You don't want to come to a cup final. Alan Stubbs has said himself that you come to a cup final and you lose a cup final, then nobody remembers you, and it often works out to be quite an awful day for you. I remember myself standing down there and watching the opposition taking the cup and enjoying the celebrations afterwards, and believe me, you've been that day. You don't remember it at all. It's only when you lift the trophy that you actually remember it. You look back and you savour it. So I think when you get here, and it's such a hard task to get here, and so few clubs do it, and there's not a great deal of players going about that have done it in many occasions. So when you get the chance, you've got to want to win the trophy this afternoon. The domestic situation in terms of league campaign is put to bed, and you're fully focused on the game today, this special occasion in front of your fans. You want to send them home happy. You want to have a memory yourself. You want to give them memories. Enjoy and savour the afternoon, but most importantly, lift that trophy, because if you don't, nobody will remember the day, believe me.
Yeah, we've heard both Leanne Dempsey and Alan Stubbs before her, Barry, saying not even thinking about next week, and actually quite often when you hear players, managers, whatever, saying that, you think, yeah, I'll bet, but actually, you've got to absolutely accept that today. You've got to believe that today. This, everything is about what's happening today, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I mean, you know, Lam's talking about promotion, that the focus 100% is on today, and then guess what, after today the focus becomes 100% on the Scottish Cup on Wednesday in Inverness, and then after that, and then only then can we then decide, okay, but you know, where are we going to go next? Because it's going to be a really hard ask for Hibs to get promotion stuff. It's obviously it's going to be through the playoff system, and at the minute they're in a dogfight for second as well, so they're going to have a lot of hard work to do before they can get back to the Premiership. Yes, listen, most people want a good Hibs team in the top flight, and we want Edinburgh derbies, but absolutely, but no one has a divine right to do that, and these players have got to go out and earn that. But he said that's in the back burner today. All they'll be thinking about, as well, he said, is winning a trophy. It's in England, 10 minutes into the second half at the Emirates, it's Arsenal 0, Watford 1 in the FA Cup quarter final. Odion Ighalo, top scorer for Watford, getting that one early in the second half, his 17th goal of the season. Remember, Crystal Palace, Everton, both
through to the semi-finals. Watford now leading away to Arsenal, and it's Manchester United against West Ham United in the later game. That's a 4 o'clock kickoff. It's a 3 o'clock kickoff here at Hampden Park, Hibernian and Ross County, getting ever closer to getting this first final of the season up and running. Let's just stick with him then. One man who'll certainly be hoping there'll be sunshine and Leith this afternoon is one of the Proclaimer twins, Charlie Reid. Spoke earlier with Martin.
I'm here with Charlie Reid of Proclaimer's fame. A big game for you, Charlie. How are you feeling going into this?
Very positive. I think the team's been doing very well this season. I think it's they've been playing great football, which is excellent. And they've always, obviously, for some of the bigger games against Premier Division teams, they've really risen to the occasion. So, yeah, I'm quite optimistic.
We've got a good record, you point to, against Premiership teams, but the last few weeks maybe a bit more cagey, a bit more nervy going into this one, given the results there.
Aye, I wonder if the pile up of fixtures is kind of getting to them, the realisation that it's probably going to be playoff now towards the end of the season. A lot of games to play, maybe the concentration's going a bit, but certainly I'm sure the concentration will be 100% for today.
Who are you looking out for to perform for you today?
I think obviously Cummings has had an outstanding season, but in terms of watching the side, I think McGinn has been phenomenal, but I mean the whole team has been great, but I just wonder if it's Stokes' day, maybe he can shine today.
He's not quite delivered as far as most people see, but yeah, the big occasion might suit him.
Maybe he's still settling in. I don't know how he's social life's going, but I think if he's sort of sell out the day, he'll do very well and he'll score.
Your thoughts on Alan Stubbs? He really seems to have transformed things and put you in a really positive mood.
I think he's magnificent. I think him, like Tony Mowbray, they really stand out as Hibs managers in my lifetime, obviously along with Eddie Turnbull. And there's two things you've got to do, Easter, is you've got to entertain people and you've got to make them feel that they're bringing through young players and they're playing it the right way, and I think he's done that superbly.
And at this stage, you think he deserves a trophy?
I think you deserve it when you win it, and I think he's a winner, so I think he's going to do it the right way.
Brilliant. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Enjoy the game.
Charlie Reid, as he was heading inside Hampden just a little while back, chatting with Martin Dowden. The two sets of players are going through their paces down below us, getting towards the end of their warm-up. I suppose it's round about now, Willie, that realisation begins to kick in. You get that shout from the coaches, you're back up that tunnel.
I think so, yeah. I mean, it looks as though they're now just doing their own little thing out there, maybe working in pairs. Maybe they've got their own routine, you know, because enough a lot of it nowadays is organised, isn't it? Sports scientists saw them out earlier with a rubber band round their legs, they're stretching as well, which always intrigues me. I think it's a way forward, obviously, and that's what the sports scientists say you should do. But now, I think you need a little bit of time on your own. You need to kind of be able to prepare yourself for a game as important as this. You need to try and get your mind and focus. You've got to, you know, try to think, how am I going to start this game, for instance? You know, what is the first thing I want to do? Do I want to have, you know, a good pass, a good header, good tackle? I think the first thing you do in the game is really important. I think it sets the standard for the rest of the cup final. And, you know, the games don't come more important than a game like this afternoon. So your preparation is really key to it. And I think that individual preparation, yeah, you'll be thinking about the club, you'll be thinking about lifting a trophy at the end of the day, you'll be thinking about your family who undoubtedly will all be here to cheer you on, your friends and your relations, but you've then got to bin that, you know, and try to get that out of your mind now and fully focus on what you intend to do this afternoon, because it's really key that although you're playing in a team, that your individual performance is of the highest level. If you can get an individual performance at the top level and a team group performance at the same level as well, then I'll tell you what, you've got a real chance of winning the trophy.
Yeah, I mean, it is one of the things. I mean, when you're a manager, you have to worry about everyone, Barry, don't you? As a player, yes, you have to be part of that whole team thing, but there'll be a lot of guys out there just hoping that personally they can go out and show what they can do this afternoon in a cup final.
Yeah, you get a mix of, you know, it's a good mix of players. You know, you have your...
Hey Myra, see the lily fair, the blushing rose just newly blown. Then view thy lovely face, and there you'll find that beauty's all your own. The song
right
to Myra.
The shed right there, the door's